On my first day back in Brussels, Harris took me out to lunch, and there was a Reclaim the Streets protest going on with hundreds of skaters flowing through the city. It was really spectacular to watch, but I'm not entirely sure what they were protesting, as there wasn't a banner or anything. I kind of feel that defeats the point of a protest if nobody knows what you're protesting about, but it was really cool to see. And of course, I was reunited with my beloved seasonal poke bowl. On the way home, we saw these awesome musicians outside a bar. Morning, Harris brought home a cache of delightful pastries from his favourite bakery.
Here we see the unveiling of the croissant.
They were absolute heaven.
Jam, I think. This is pistachio and chocolate. Or this is pistachio and chocolate, and this is vanilla chocolate and almonds. And this is very nice, with crème pâtisserie, voilà.
This is joy on a plate.
Rob had already left for a conference, and Harris was on his way to America the next day, so I took a crash course on how to water the plants. This is a clever system. You put one end in the plant pot and the other in a bucket of water, and it keeps everything hydrated whilst you're away. Then we headed across town to visit a funfair. It has been years since I went to one of these, and I was rather excited. First order of the day was a drink. We sipped our beer and watched the unfortunate souls suspended in the sky whilst people got on and off at the bottom. Then it was our turn.
Hey! Excited!
Oh God! Mom, I love you, okay? Peace out! Right?
And watched this one for a long time. Harris was well up for it, but I was a bit more hesitant with a pint of beer in my tummy and the threat of lightning in the sky. As the rain started to come down, I spotted something that was a bit more my style.
Thank you.
even high definition.
After that, it was time for some food. My dad used to take me to Butlins on holiday. This was one of my favourite pastimes. You make the horses move by rolling balls into holes. Different coloured holes give you a different number of moves. The first horse past the post wins the prize. Whoa! Crane games have really changed since I was a kid. Time. I can't help looking at the prices here and thinking it must be pretty tough if you're a family with kids. Most of the rides were €5 each, and the food definitely wasn't cheap. When I was a kid, rides were between 50 pence and £1.50, and you could get a bag of donuts for a quid.
I love Pennywise.
As the rain got heavier, we took shelter in a bar. I have fond memories of the log flume. My dad used to take me to Alton Towers and American Adventure. The log flume absolutely terrified me, but in a good way. After all the fun of the fair, we headed across town to Jardin, which is an old hospital that was turned into a bar.
Welcome to an incredibly rainy Brussels. Harris and I have just trekked across the whole city to get to the Jardin bar. He's just gone out to get some beer, and we are sitting in perhaps the last dry bench in the garden. So there's loads of like benches, but only a handful have got like coverings. So we've got one of the last ones of those. He's gone to get something to drink, and we're just gonna hang out here for a bit. But my hair was absolutely dry when we started walking, and now it's just, you know, send help.
Voilà.
Hooray!
We were treated to a lovely rainbow though, and it even turned into a double bow. That evening, the whole sky turned bright pink. It was a beautiful sunset to end my holidays.